Hi, I'm Adam Fennig with Fennig Equipment.
Jeff Worley with Yetter Farm Equipment.
And we're here at the 2018 National Farm Machinery Show, and things have been pretty busy this week. But we want to talk about a really hot topic, and that's the no-till culvert. You know, we've talked a lot about whether we need it or whether we don't. So we wanted to talk to Jeff about what he's been seeing this week.
Yeah, well, what we see with the no-till culvert, Adam, no-till culvert really isn't our friend, is what I like to tell guys. A lot of guys think that they can plant without a no-till culvert. And we just see time in and time out that that's just not the case. I mean, the added downforce on our row unit needed to put our culvert in the ground is huge. And so that's definitely a negative because we don't want a lot of down pressure there. The other thing is the blade bringing dirt out of the seed drill.
Correct.
So definitely making sure that we don't compromise our seed depth basically with the culvert.
Yeah, and something to keep in mind, if you're going in no-till situations, like Jeff said, you're going to need more down pressure to get that planter in the ground. And also, that no-till culvert is in control of that row unit. Anything felt by the blade is then felt by the seed tube, and we sacrifice our consistent seed depth and spacing, and in the end, it converts into yield. So if we take that off, what are we then going to do?
Well, the best way we can do, or the thing we can do, is basically just put a set of row cleaners on, a set of floating row cleaners. Basically, it's going to help us also with our leverage out front. You see, when we wrap around the no-till culvert, we're sticking out 25 inches.
Yeah.
So just imagine how far we are away from our planter gauge width.
So adjustments, you know, a quarter inch here is more like a half inch out here. It's hard to get that zone.
Exactly. It's hard to find the sweet spot because we may be digging too deep and sometimes not deep enough. So by moving our row cleaners back, like here where we're 14 inches sticking out forward, it allows us to control it quite a bit more.
Yeah, and you know, this row cleaner, it floats real nice. Like Jeff said, tighter to the row unit. And also, it costs a little bit more money to wrap around that culvert. You know, we get rid of it. We have no more blades out front to replace. No hairpinning effects. No chances of a false bottom. And let your double disc openers go to work. They're completely capable of opening that slot and let the row cleaners clear out the residue. I hear it time and time again of guys running no-till culverts in conventional ground, and that really confuses me.
I really don't understand conventional ground. That culvert is absolutely doing nothing.
In fact,
zero.
Yeah.
And most guys, their argument is, well, it helps wear on my seed disc opener blades. Well, at the end of the day, really, we should, every year, we need to replace those seed disc blades. Because we get one pass across that field to put seed in the ground, and there's no reward to see how long you can wear them down. And we're going to be looking at skips and possibly double. I mean, just worn seed displays are, it's just a must to keep them up to speed.
Correct. And what we wanted to get through to you guys is if you're going to make one change to your planter this year, consider taking the no-till culvert off. I'm talking beans or corn planter. Take it off and try out a row cleaner, or even a bare faceplate is better than a no-till culvert. But get a hold of us, maybe try a row cleaner or two. You know, we also build in the Precision Clean Sweep bracket. In the future, you can always drop in a bracket at any time. So, you know, like we said, these float much easier to adjust, shorter couple, and everything about it kind of ties into better yields and better seed placement.
You're exactly right, Adam. I challenge growers all the time, asking what should I do, and I say, put one row on, because it's your conditions, your soil type, your everything. And I just have seen so many guys try it, and they can't believe, without the culture, what their stands look like with just the row cleaner. So definitely it's a good thing, you know, to give me a call and to get a row unit to try.
Absolutely. It all starts out front with clearing away that trash. That helps so much with your fertilizer placement, your seed placement, and also closing the trench out back. Like Jeff said, if you want to try a row, give us a shout. We can help you out and send one out your way for this spring. That's us tuning in here at the National Farm Machinery Show. Thank you.